shadows disappear, the animals inside came out to play. Went face to face with all our fears, learned our lessons through the tears, made memories we knew would never fade. One day my father, he told me, son, don't let it slip away. He took me in his arms and heard him say,
alright everyone, what is up? It's your boy K-Not Suzuki here, back at it again with another new spankin' hot what if video. And today, or tonight, or whenever you're watching this, I have a new what if. This is called What If Deku Was the Demon King of Flame. Or Bone and Flame, to be more specific, but, well, I have to make the name a bit short. Short and vague, of course. Like most of my what ifs. Now, I know what y'all thinking. Does this have to do something with Demon Slayer? Because I friggin' see Demon King Tanjiro on the screen and probably on the thumbnail. Now, no, Demon King Tanjiro is... Yes, the pictures are Demon King Tanjiro, but no, this has nothing to do with Demon Slayer, okay? I only picked these pictures because, I mean, seriously, it's the most badass Demon King I can think of. And that basically is saying a lot. I mean, seriously. Now, as Deku will be the Demon King of Bone and Flame. The ship will be the Demon Queen. I have only told one person, who I hope they don't tell anyone else. But just pause the video right now, after I'm done talking, of course, and just tell me, who do you think the ship will be? And who do you think the Demon Queen will be? Just pause the video, type in your answers, okay? You have 10 seconds to do that. And, well, yeah. Let's get on with this. As we go to many, many, many years ago, before Deku was the Demon King, as his father would have been the previous Demon King, of course, as Deku would be just sitting on a balcony of a castle, of a giant palace. And when I mean giant, I mean this palace is about 100 times larger. About 100 times larger than this palace itself is about 100 times larger than New York City. Than New York itself. So yeah, it's a big palace. As this palace is, of course, on the highest peak of hell. Deku is just on the balcony. He just sitting there. As his father walks up behind him and says, "Son," as he then says, "Izuku, is there a problem?" As Deku looks at his dad and he says, "No, father, why would there be a problem?" As the Demon King then says, "Izuku, I know when you're lying, tell me, what is the issue? As Izuku and as Deku would then say, "Well, father, looks like I can't keep even the smallest things from you." As he'd then say, "Fine, I'll tell. But don't judge me, okay?" As the Demon King would then say, "Fine, I won't judge you." As Deku would then say, "I'm bored. I'm bored with this place, with hell, demons, all of it. I'm just so bored. And I know that you're going to be retiring soon. And I completely understand you wanting to retire. But, Dad, just, how can I explain this? I'm bored. I want to go. I want to be free. Okay?" As Demon King, hearing the same thing from his son for the 100th and for the millionth time. Sorry about that. As the Demon King would just sigh and look down at Izuku and at Deku as he'd then say, "Izuku, I've told you this for the millionth time, I'm for, well, 999,000 times. 999,999 times. This is the millionth time, quite literally, that you have asked me to go to the human world." As the Demon King would then look at Deku as he'd then sigh and say, "But I guess before you, you know, you have to live a life of responsibility, I suppose, before you, you know, become Demon King, I suppose, because your coronation, even though it's in 10 years, I suppose that I could let you go out, okay? Just be careful." As Deku would then rush over to his dad and hug him as he'd then say, thank you. You won't regret it, I swear." As Deku would then stop hugging his dad, as he would then skip out of the palace and would run towards a portal. He'd still be in the palace, as, of course, the Demon King's family has special portals already in their palace. As Deku would hop in one of these portals, as Deku would then basically walk in and would then be in a forest. As Deku would then get a mental message from his father saying, "You have one day, and you have one day, understood? 24 hours. Maybe I'll let you come out again." As Deku would then say, "Understood, father." As Deku would rush over to a human village. Now, of course, he would look like this, not exactly any changes other than the eyes, the teeth, and, you wouldn't exactly be able to tell from the teeth because, Deku does not have sharp, you know, demon fangs yet. He does not have demonic talons. He does not have these giant, huge, and terrifying demonic talons for teeth. No, not yet, exactly. As Deku just has only 4 sharp teeth. And 2 really sharp teeth. Well, no, 4 really sharp teeth. 2 at the top and 2 at the bottom, of course. As Deku would... Now, Deku would basically walk over to the human village, as he'd then see some humans, you know, just talking, trading. Basically, it'd be like a normal Tuesday for them, but for Deku, this would be a once, quite literally, in his entire life chance. This is the first time he's ever gone to the human world, to the mortal world. And he is absolutely just fascinated with the way human beings think. As he then sees humans have carriages, and he sees all sorts of things, such as wizards, mages, warriors, barbarians, witches, warlocks, assassins, knights, and he even sees that humans have a less sophisticated royal family. And less sophisticated royals, as he then says, Man, the human world is so amazing. As we skip about 23, as we skip about 23 hours and 30 minutes, Deku has 30 minutes left on the human world, and in the human world, as he's just, you know, trying to get the most fun he can out of these 24 hours. As Deku sees a chase going down, he sees some knights on horses chasing after a thief on a big black horse with armor on it. As Deku basically is following this and this chase, as he then sees a child right in the middle of the street. As Deku sees this young 4-year-old girl basically just playing in the street, as he then says, "Oh dear," as he sees the chase basically going right towards her, as Deku does the only possible option that he could have had, and rushes as fast as possible, without even thinking, grabs the child and rolls out of safety. And he rolls out of the way with the child in his hands over to safety. However, the knights see Deku, they see his eyes and the marks on his face, and they see his just, right now they're just very, they're just a bit sharper than normal sharp nails, but eventually they'll turn into giant claws. As they see Deku, basically they see a demon with a child in their in his hands, and what to make matters even worse, a bunch of royal priests and a bunch of royal guards then run over towards the girl and say, "Demon, you fiend! How dare you try to attack the Princess Vanessa?" As Deku then is confused, as he then says, "Wait, what? No, you've got it wrong." As then they say, "Shut up, beast!" As they then punch him in the face and against a tree. As the knights then grab their blades and begin attacking Deku with not only swords, but hammers, axes, and other things. As some wizards were, as a couple of wizards were watching everything go down, as the wizards are not pleased with the knights and with the warriors, as they then walk over to them and say, "What are you doing? This man was a this boy was a hero, and you're just beating the crap out of him." As they then say, "Did you not see? He's a demon. He just had his hands on the princess and was probably going to eat her." As the wizard would try to explain what, but the knights would be so full of themselves that they wouldn't have it. As a big knight with a axe would then, and as a big knight with a great sword, word and golden and silver, gold and white armor would walk out of nowhere, as he'd then say, "Don't worry, never fear, I shall kill this dastardly beast." As he then lifts up his sword, rushes at Deku, and goes for a swing. As then we hear a sound of what appeared to be a clash and then breaking metal. As Deku would be shaking, as he'd then look upward and would see his father, and as he'd then see his younger brother by one year, here with a staff and with a sword, basically blocking the blow. As the knight's sword would have shattered when it clashed with Deku's brother's sword, as he'd then say, "Hey, what the hell happened, Hanzuku? As he'd then say, I don't know. All I did was. As the knights would then, as then suddenly 100 more knights and 10 more knights would rush out of nowhere, as they would try to stab Deku and his brother. As another brother of Deku's, younger than the younger brother by two days would walk out of nowhere. As the knights would still be outnumbering and surrounding the brothers, as the brothers still, the brothers honored the treaty that their father, and that their father and the first human king had. So they would not hurt the demons, and would not hurt the humans, unless one of them actually drew blood. As then a man wearing gold and white armor with a crown on would rush out of nowhere with an axe in hand, as he would then swing his axe down at Deku, as it would draw one drop of blood from his cheek. Let me just tell you, bad decision. as just after the dr- as when the drop of blood hit the very ground at that very moment, almost absolutely instantly, a giant demon, and a demon who is 8 feet tall, all with four wings and four horns, would appear out of nowhere. This demon would have a bident. If you don't know what a bident is basically like a trident, except take away the point in the middle, okay? As that's basically the weapon of the underworld. Hades' bident, or in Greek mythology, it's also known as Hades' bident. Then there's Poseidon's trident and Zeus's lightning bolt. As he would have. And as. Now, this demon would have a black and a black, red, and gray crown on, and a black beard, and two black and red eyes and sharp teeth. As the demon, as in the human world, and his skin was black, was like a dark charcoal like color. But when he was on the human world, his dark charcoal-like skin would turn into black, like a black smoky texture that would be floating upward. As the demon would then say, "You dare break our treaty, and what's even worse, spill not only a demon's blood, but my eldest, the next demon king's blood." As the human king would then say, "You're the demon lord, Azarath." As the human would then say, "I'm sorry. As the demon king, now known as Azarath, and now introduced as Azarath, would then say, "Save it. Save your human, and save your mortal apologies for someone who will actually listen. You just violated the treaty." As he would then say, "And as for that, any beings of any kind that are not full human will leave humanity alone." As he would then snap his fingers, as suddenly any human and any humanoid being and any person who could use magic, such as sorcerers, witches, mages, or anything like that, would then basically walk away, and would basically then leave the village. As a man, and as he suddenly, elves, dwarfs, and everything else would escape the village, and would then run out of the village and take all of their possessions, leaving the village, and not only just this entire village, the entire human world. All possessions of magic would be gone, and all magic beings would leave. As he would then say, "And because of what you have done, you filthy human king, for touching and for spilling my son's blood, I curse you and your family." as you, who, as when you reach the age of 50, human king, your flesh will begin to fall off, your hair will begin to decay, your skin will begin to rot, and your bones will turn to ash, and when you die and enter the underworld, which, of course, for breaking the treaty, there's no possible way in that you would ever, will ever go to heaven, as he'd then say, and for breaking the treaty, and, well, you will go, and when you come to the underworld, you will be there as a rotting, hideous, monstrous corpse. And I will mangle you even worse, so that every woman, every being, everyone in the entirety of the underworld will look at you in fear and horror, and would say, and you, and I will mangle everything about you except for your ears. And your eyes, because I want you to see and hear everyone shriek in terror of the horrible, mangled creature that you will become. As he would then grab the human king by the neck and would throw him on the ground, as he would then say, "Hey, this world will now be magicless forever." As he would then, as the Demon King would then summon a black and red grip sword out of nowhere, as he then stab it into the ground, as suddenly a giant dome of red and black electricity would surround the 40 demons and would scorch the ground, as then they would be teleported to the underworld. As, well, oof. Now we go to another part of hell, as we see another demon. This demon, of course, is, hold on. My god. Yes, I mean, seriously, that's just very, very, very annoying and stupid. Like, I ain't even joking. Like, I mean, how can I explain how annoying this is? So, she wants to get with Sasuke, right? Of course, she's all like, "Sasuke-kun!" And then she's yelling at Naruto, who is an orphan, by the way, and says maybe if he had some parents, they would teach him manners. And he's a demon, all that. And you know what ticks me off? Same thing as this guy. She's talking terribly about an orphan in front of another orphan. For the same reasons. Not having parents and no one to teach him right or wrong. Right? I just want to... At times like that, I just wanted to... have the ability to reach into the TV, grab Sakura by the hair, grab my great sword off my wall, and decapitate her ass. However, sadly, it never happened. So boo. Back to what ifs. As on the other side of hell, we see another demon. And we see another royal demon family. As this demon is called, and as this demon family is called the Ayurozus. Now, there are two families of all of hell. Hell, and of the entire underworld, that are the strongest and are royalty. One of them being the Ayurozu, and the other being the Midoriya. The Midoriya, of course, are stronger than the Irozu by 50%. I'm by 3 times over. As the Irozu understand that they will never be as strong as Midoriya, and accept this. As we go to Momo Yairozu, the next demon queen. As she's just basically sitting in her room as her mother rushes in and says, "As Momo, we have bad news." As she then looks at her parents and says, "What's the bad news?" As they then say, "How can I explain this?" And as her mother then basically sits down to her and says, "Izuku has been cut. Izuku went to the human world. Yesterday, and he went to the human world today for 24 hours, and apparently there was a misunderstanding, and the human king himself swung his axe at Izuku and drew blood." As Momo would then hold both of her hands over her mouth, as she would then cry. As she would then say, "Is Izu alright?" As Momo's mother would then say, "Yes, he's perfectly fine. However, that does mean that the Treaty of Humans and Demons is over, and the human world is now magicless." As she would then say, "Good, those filthy humans deserve it for hurting my Izu. In fact, they deserve 1,000 times worse." As her parents would then say, "We know, Momo, we know. But disappointingly, that's the worst it's going to get until the human family dies." As she would then say, "Huh?" As they would then say, "The entire human royal the entire royal family of the humans will die. I, as in their entire bloodline, will, of course, come to the underworld. And they will be, how can I explain this, tortured beyond anything you could imagine. All because of that one human king's mistake." As she would then say, "Good. Good." As we go back to Izuku. As he's just lying, as he's just sitting down on his bed, thinking about his entire life. As he had always wanted to go to the surface, but he never thought that just because he was a demon, people would instantly hate him when they saw him touching another human. Even protecting one. As Deku would just be contemplating his entire life. As Azarath would basically knock on the door, as he would then walk in, as he'd then say, "Son, I understand you're in a bad place right now, but can you please just tell me what happened to make the Human King want to hurt you like that?" As Deku would then say, "I won't tell. Bad things might happen." As Azarath would then say, "Izuku, I can't help you unless you tell me." As Deku would then say, "Fine." There was a chase, and there was a chase against a human thief, and, well, These knights and the thief, who are all on horses, nearly ran over this girl. This 4-year-old little girl, who was just playing in the road. I rushed over and grabbed her and got her out of the way of danger. However, human knights saw me and attacked me for touching her. They called me a beast, a fiend, a demon, which, I mean, we are. I am, but I don't like being called that by anyone who isn't a demon. Or at least when they're not using it as a political term. As the Demon King would then just hug his son, as he would then cry, and as in his mind, the Demon King would be angry beyond recognition. As in the human world, a terrible great famine had came over the village, as all magic which they were even using to grow their crops would, and, well, supply them with water, would instantly stop as soon as the treaty was broken, as they would be in a terrible, hungry famine, as suddenly black clouds would surround the castle where all the highest village and where all the highest people in the village and every single knight and everyone of status was there. As suddenly, from the black clouds, red lightning would appear as it would then strike down in the middle of the castle, breaking through the door and breaking through the roof, as the Demon King would then, and as Azrath would then appear, as he would then say, "You fools," as he would be visibly angry, as they would then say, "Huh? What do you mean? What are you calling us fools for? We're already in trouble enough for hurting your son." As he'd then say, "Oh, that isn't even the worst of it." As he would then snap his fingers and Deku would teleport and would appear right and would walk. Well, no, he wouldn't snap his fingers. As he'd then say, "Izu, can you please tell them exactly what you told me? And even show them." As Deku would walk out from behind Azrath, as he'd then say, "Yes, Dad." As he would walk up in front of the humans and knights, as he'd then say, "I didn't mean any harm by touching the princess. In fact, quite the opposite. You see, I was walking around and I saw this chase happening. These thieves and there was knights chasing them and they were all on horses. And the chase was intense and no one was paying attention to what was in front of them. And I saw a 4-year-old girl playing in the middle of the road and you were heading right for her. My instincts kicked in, I rushed over and grabbed her and brought her out of danger, and the next thing I know, I'm beaten and punished for it. I'm attacked and punished for it." As Izuku would then say, "I just don't understand. I was helping. I was good. I rescued her and saved her life. And you repay me by calling me a beast, a fiend, and a demon, while not using it politically, but more such as a selfish term. As he would then say, "Why?" As the demon king and everyone in the castle would just be surprised, shocked, and would feel like total shit. As everyone would then say, "Oh, God. Not only did we break the treaty, but we didn't even have a good reason to. We should have, as the knights would then think, we should have listened to the wizards. They warned us." As Arath would then say, "As for that, I hereby, I say that all of you, except the 4-year-old girl, will have the terrible plagues that I've mentioned earlier. As for the 4-year-old girl, she will be brought by my youngest son, Ethel, and Adriel, to the last place of magic on Earth. While it is weak magic, it is still magic." As he would then say, "Adriel, as a demon with one wing and two horns and one red eye and one normal-looking eye would appear. As Adriel is known as Adriel the Halfling. He is half demon, half human. As he would then say, "Yes, Father." As Arath would then say, "Bring this young child to the church of Zalamar." As he would then say, "Yes, Father." As Adriel would then grab the child, would then walk over and hold the child's hand. As suddenly blue lightning would surround the two as they would then teleport away. As Arath would then say, "As for all of you, as an addition to all of the hell and torture you are all getting, your entire family will suffer a curse, except for the king. Your entire family will suffer the curse of dying before they reach the age of 18. I don't even care if it's been 10,000 years, if it is 10,000 years later. Before they reach the age of 18, all of this royal family, except those that are directly descended from that girl, and except that girl, will die." As they would then say, "Wait, but won't that mean that our entire family will just be disgraced? And what of her? She will die and go to hell." As the demon king would then, as Azarath would then say, no, she will not. In fact, she will be, yeah. She'll be at the church of Zath, and she will be at the church of Zathar. If you do not know, the church of Zathar is the last place of magic on this world, and it is actually a home of the angel, of the half angels. And, of course, full angels and archangels as well. As he would then say, there she will be brought up as a priestess. And there she will be She will be raised as a priestess, and within time, she will become my son's maid. As he would then say, such is the will, and such is my will. As he would then say, now, to make it official, I hereby remove the curse of I Azeroth hereby remove the curse of the Araraka princess Ochako Araraka. As he would then snap his fingers, as white lightning and as yellow lightning would appear and would strike down at the child, and at the child who was at the church of Zathar. As he and Deku would then disappear. As Deku and his dad would basically teleport back into their palace, as Deku's dad would then say, if you want to postpone the preparations, that's perfectly fine. As Deku would then say, no. In fact, I would like the coronation ceremony to be tomorrow. If you don't mind, of course. I just want to speed things along. So I can lock up the gates forever. As Azeroth would be shocked by his son's words, but would then say, okay. As the next day, it would be coronation. As Deku's marks would begin to become like magma or fire. As Azeroth would then say, it appears you will be the Demon King of Flame. As then unexpectedly, 13 giant, sort of long, bone-like tendrils, or 10 tentacles, made out of bone, or giant pieces of rib, or giant spines, basically, would form out of Deku's back. As he would then say, never mind, he will be the Demon King of Bone and Flame. As he'd then say, long live Demon King Izuku. As we skip many, 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 many years later. As by now, humans have gained, by now, using illegal necromancies, humans have gained the power of the weakest form of magic possible, quirks. However, by using these illegal necromancies, all the angels have left the world. Even the half-angels. And archangels and, well, the only one of the Church of Zathar that is left is Araraka. As we see Deku basically sitting down on his throne, as he then says, you know what? It's been thousands of years. I want to go to the human world again. To test them. and I want to go to the human world again. As he then said, but this time I want my wife there with me. Now, of course, they would not, and Deku would not say why he wanted to go back to the human world. As Momo would appear right and would walk out from behind Deku, as he would then say, wait, why do you want to go back to the human world? Didn't you lock the gates? As he would then say, I did, but well, father, there is a priestess there. One unknown as Ochaka or Araka. We will go there and observe her. If she is truly a peaceful human and I had not risked my life for nothing, she will be given the gift of, she will be given a gift to live down here with us as my second wife. However, if I have if she uses her life wrongly, I will have to bring forth the arm, the entire force of the underworld, and the entire armadas of hell towards the mortal realm. As he would then open his palm as a portal would open up in front of the two. As Deku would then say, Momo, are you coming? I should then say, of course. I didn't come with you the last time, and look what happened. This time I'm coming just for your security. And to make sure no regular weak humans who have cheated the laws of everything, and to get the weakest forms of magic, try to get you, okay? As he then say, fine by me. As they would then walk through a portal. As they then hold hands and walk through the portal. And that's where I'm ending this part off. Hope you all have enjoyed part one of what if Deku was the demon king of flame. Aim. So I hope y'all have enjoyed. Please like, share, comment, subscribe. Do whatever you want. If I have notifications, please press them for more excellent videos. And I hope to see y'all later. Please like. And, goodbye and skadoo.